Hi, Kathy here from Kathy's Cute Creations. Today we're going to do the bee. I'm so excited. Let me show you what I'm using. First off, this is what I buy. Now, this product has changed over the years. This actually feels like a piece of paper. You can hear it rattle. This side is a little bit bumpy and this side is not. Now, when they first came out with this back in, I don't know when they came out with it, back in the 80s is when I used it for the first time when I did some embroidery work. It actually felt like a Ziploc bag does. Okay, so one of your quart Ziploc bags. And what it does is that you take it and you mark it, which I'm going to show you here. I've marked mine. I cut my paper in half. I marked her name. This is the baby's name. And then you pin this or lay it. Here's the bee. I got it, the stuffing out of the bee. And I'm going to put it on the belly here. So you take this piece of paper. If I can get my hand on it, you take this piece of paper. And you lay it across like this, wherever you want to place the name. And you pin it. Now, on the other side, you want something a little bit stiff. Some kind of stabilizer. Normally, this paper, you can use as many sheets as you want. Once you dip that in water, it's gone. Right now, it's a little bit more flimsier than a piece of paper, but it is a little stiff. So you can use tearaway or anything on the other side. If you want to put a piece of fabric on the other side, you could do that. You can use anything you want. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to layer a couple of pieces of this paper because I'm going to fold this other sheet in half. And I'm going to put it, because it does cover it. I did my first practice word was on this sheet, so that was that sheet. I'm just folding it in half. And then I went and I took it over the top of that to see that it would fit over it. So it does fit. So I'm going to put it like that underneath on the inside. If I feel like it's still not stiff enough, then I'll just get some more tear away is what I'll use, because I can cut that away. So let me get over here to the sewing machine and show you. Now, I'm not doing this in a hoop. I'm doing this so that all of you that have a zigzag sewing machine can do it also. I want everybody to be able to do this. Okay, I don't want you to have to go out and buy a specific machine. I mean, it can be the cheapest machine as long as it has a straight stitch, which they all come with a straight stitch, and a zigzag. It doesn't need any special feet or anything, because this is where you're going to be dropping your feed dogs, unless you have a machine that you cover them up.
So I'm preparing the bee.
All I did was took the paper, put it up inside, right here, and what I'm doing is trying to figure out where I'm going to position it. So I'm positioning it right up underneath the head. Now this is to make it more stable, okay? That's all I'm doing. I'm trying to line it up in the middle. Sticking the one with the name where I want to put it. I think I want to put it right there. And then I'm pinning it. Attempting to pin it without pinning myself. Let's put it that way. That's what I'm trying to do. And I will show you here if I can't get it in camera. I'm trying to pin it as far away from me so I don't get stuck when I go to sewing it. See, you see the pins. I'm going to try to put my pins upward like that. Pin away from that a little bit. And one across the top up here. Alright, so get a better picture of it. Here's what it looks like. Okay? Okay, so when I put it up underneath my sewing machine, her head's gonna be in the way. I've got to put her name down lower. So I have my foot for the embroidery, so it drops down my feed dogs automatically when I select it, And remember this box of assorted, I'm going to show you here, needles? Well, in that box, there's some embroidery needles. So I'm using the 90. And now you're thinking, oh my goodness, you know, you go to all this and what happens if it doesn't work? Well, I'm going to tell you what happens. You ad lib, okay? So let's say it doesn't work for some reason. I have my machine is all cleaned out. Let me see if it will thread it with this needle. No, it didn't, so it's being picky today. Anyway, so if it doesn't work and I can't get it to work, then I can either hand embroider it or I can go and, oops, let me see if I can clean this a bit. I can do hand work on it, like I said, embroider it, or I can do applique. So even if it doesn't work out like I want it to, you can always change it. I mean, the baby's not gonna care. You might care, but the baby isn't. Alrighty, so here we go. Let's see if I can get it started. And hopefully y'all can see this. Let me see if I can, let's see, can I get you closer? Okay. Okay. Now let's see. So the first thing and the main thing is make sure that the other side, which is the back side of the bumblebee here, is not underneath. Okay, so let's see if you can see it. There we go. You can see my paper down there. Okay, so the back side, he's not underneath. And you have to do this like any other embroidery project. Let me see if I can get close enough. Okay, you gotta put your needle down and bring it up. Just like any other. So let's put my foot down. And let me see, my length is fine, but my width needs to be tighter. So let's see, how tight can I go here with my width and my length? Okay, so my width, the most I can do with my width is a 7, which I think is fine. As far as the length, we want to make it tight. So we want to make, in my machine, you make the number smaller. Because what you're trying to achieve is the satin stitch. I hope this has you close enough. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do, I have my length at 0, my width at 7, and I'm gonna bring up the thread first, and the other side is not underneath there. I've made sure. Keeping in mind that my width is at 7 right now, so it's going to make a great big huge sweep for this E, which is fine, but I want to lock it in place first. Right there. There we go. All right, here we go. This out of here because that's bothering me. Oops. We can always go back it over it if we have to. Done. This is my paper smacking. Take a peek at that. And there's our E. All right, let's go to the V. Okay, back over to the other side. Yeah, there we go. I just wanted to lock it in place a couple times. Let's move this out of the way. And here we go. Something broke. All right, let's start it over. Oh, got a bird's nest. All right, let's get that fixed. Glad it started at the beginning. Uh-oh. I'm gonna have to probably take my... gonna have to take it apart because I can see it down in there. All right, gonna be a minute. Okay, so what I did was, I'm continuing on this A. I cleaned out the machine. When I got done, I did a test drive with my regular, I always go back to normal, like I was just starting to do something, just a regular stitch, to make sure that it worked. Then I went ahead, reset back my sewing machine. The thing that I did is that I took the paper underneath, and it was like this, and where it had a hole, because I punched the holes, I took my paper, and it's two pieces now, because remember, it's folded underneath there. That's two pieces of paper. See how it's folded here? So it's two pieces of paper, and all I did was I took it, and I folded it down over the part that already had the holes made from the fabric jam nest underneath my machine, when it created a nest underneath my plate. So that's what I did. I made it so that that wouldn't be exposed. To get rid of it, I doubled over the paper. So all it did was cover the holes that were in the paper. Okay, let's see. This is going to bother me, so I got to get rid of that. the bottom. Okay. So then I went ahead and tested it to make sure it worked. So I'm just continuing on, is all I'm doing. Let's see if I can. For some reason it would not lock into place. I'm not quite sure why it wouldn't lock into place this time around. So what I'm gonna do is take my width off. Can I get it off? There, yes, I can get my width off. So now what I'm gonna do is let me just see if it will let me stitch in place now. Since I don't have any kind of, there we go. There we go. Let's see if I can back the camera up so y'all can see it. There we go. That's her name. Not perfect, but I like it. So hold on one second. So I just went ahead and clipped all the scragglies off of it. As you can see, all the paper's coming off. All I did was just grabbed it, started going around it. That's all you do. See if I can put an iron to it and get rid of those black marks that came through.
So I can't resist. Is that not beautiful? Okay, so if you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the like button, and I will see you all next time. Thanks for watching, everybody. Bye-bye.